really call upon on the interns. They should work for nation building. They should not work for the very narrow kind of the parochial interest of earning one internship certificate. That certainly will be flowing. We will be taking care that our internship certificate should be give the details about your activities, what you have done, so that it should be a kind of a certificate which should have a value in your CV. And since we are going to be in touch with all kind of startups and industries, tomorrow Crime Free Bharat, any certificate for Crime Free Bharat, it would be having a great value in your CV. And on the top of it, you would be having a sense of involvement, sense of contribution in nation building. I am saying that that kind of desire, that kind of the blankness, each one of Indian must have. Because we are basically in a process where it is basically nobody working for the national cause. Now, people, political parties, they want to remain in government. Criminals are being chosen as their candidate because they are having higher benevolence. Very recently, Supreme Court has shown concern that cases are being enacted. Law are being enacted without any discussion in parliament. And they raise the concern that if there is no deliberation in the parliament, then it makes their job little difficult. Because they interpret law, they take help of the deliberation in honorable parliament so that they can understand what was the basis of or what were the basis of parliamentarian at that point of the time. Now, a larger question comes, are we operating in a democracy? So, democracy means, what is the definition of democracy? Would anyone of you would like to tell? Anybody can respond. What is democracy?
People have right to choose their leader.
Okay, that's good. Someone else?
For the people, by the people.
So basically, there are the three things. It should be government of the people, by the people, for the people. So if we say that people is in the center stage of everything, but now if you really look at the election process, is it objective? So the politicians, they are trying to exploit by dividing you in religion, in caste. They want to lower you by giving freebies. They are distributing liquor, saris, and money. So is it a fair election? Is it an election on merit?
It's not fair, sir.
Number one. Number two, I forget the election process. Now, whosoever has been elected, he has been elected on the basis of the people, those who voted, right? So let's say that they are your representative. Now, do you feel that they can speak your dream, your aspiration, your basis in parliament? Are they representing you in parliament?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, sir. No.
Of course, sir.
Yes, yes sir. Because they cannot really tell. Now, are they really representing themselves? Forget yes, about yes, you. Yes, are they representing sir. Themselves?
Yes, sir. 100%, sir.
They are not representing themselves. That is that probably that there's a finer distancing you have to understand. They are not even representing themselves.
Why, sir?
They cannot really express their inner things because they are governed by the political whip. If they speak anything against that, there are chances that their primary membership will go. Right? So they are not in position to even express themselves. Now, let's talk. Are they in position to express themselves in parliament or outside? So they are in a TV debate or they are taking a public meeting. Whether any politician can represent you or themselves. They are all the time afraid that they have to toe political lines. It means though they are voted or they are in power or they are there in parliament on account of your vote, but they are not representing you. They are not in position to represent you in parliament and they are not in position to represent you even outside the parliament. It means it is not a democracy. Do you agree we are not living in democracy?
Yes, sir. Now we are agreeing.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So if it is not a democracy, then what the term you would like to use for the present system of governance? Whether anybody would like to say something about that?
Sir,
if it is not the
democracy,
then what it is? Huh?
So it is a collective desire of political peoples. So few political have a certain desire. And that is what is governing our government right now. Or let's say that is what our politics are doing right now. Politicians being specific.
Very true. So I would like to coin a word for it. As the democracy, we can say it is a politicocracy. So it could be, if we have to give the definition as we have given of the democracy, then what is the definition of the politicocracy? It is the government of the politician, by the politicians, and for the politicians. Do you agree with this definition?
Yes, sir. We are
completely,
yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, let's talk about what are the fears. Even if the politicians, they are nationalists in their approach, then it could be the inferred desire of the public and it could be a pseudo-democracy. But it is very unfortunate that the political party, they are more irrespective of which party are they. All of them, they want anyhow to acquire power. And they are, when they are in power, they are not abiding and they are not going by our constitution, which is the basic book. Which is instrumental in giving them that political power. So I think you must have read in newspaper that our Honorable Supreme Court, it has expressed its helplessness because there was one PIL which was talking about the criminalization of the politics and the Election Commission of India and the debate was this, that the entry of criminals would be banned. They should not be allowed to compete in an election. And Supreme Court, Honorable Supreme Court has expressed its inability, its helplessness, because they said that enactment of the law or legislating a law is the responsibility of the legislature or parliamentarian. And though I feel that Supreme Court really erred in saying so, because as per the Indian Constitution, there are the two sources of any law. One source is, as you know, that it is legislated in either assembly or in parliament. And the second source comes by judicial pronouncement, and that is called the jurisprudence. There's one article in Constitution, that is article 142, it says that Supreme Court is empowered to design and wage and means to impart justice. Justice cannot be imparted if the lawmakers are criminals. So it is very unfortunate that 42% of the parliamentarians, as per their own admission, they are having criminal record, and 29% of them, they are having very, very serious criminal offenses. Those criminal offenses are of the very, very serious nature. They are very heinous, like murders, rape, etc. Now, there comes to be the two very important questions. When, if you want to become even a peon in this country, you have to be a person of a good moral character. Then if you want to become lawmaker of this country, you want to become the government of this country, why you should not be a person of the good character? What do you feel about it? हमारे रामायण में जो है एक धोबी कहता है कि अरे भाई आपकी पत्नी सीता तो जो है वो रावण की कस्टडी में था और आपने मुझे क्या राम समझ के रखा है. जब ये बात राम के कान में पहुंचती है तो गर्भवती सीता को उन्होंने जो है सिर्फ जो है एक अच्छा एग्जांपल सेट करने के लिए, वी कैन डिबेट इट ऑन कि आई मीन अबाउट द मेरिट ऑफ द डिसीजन, बट ही गेव दैट मच क्रेडेंस दैट इवन ए शैडो ऑफ डाउट शुड नॉट बी देयर. जहां शैडो ऑफ डाउट को टॉलरेट नहीं किया गया है उस देश में आर द लॉ मेकर, इट इज हाईली अनफॉर्चुनेट. एंड द पॉलिटिकल पार्टी आर नॉट गोइंग टू एनेक्ट एनी लॉ अगेंस्ट देमसेल्व्स बिकॉज ए पर्सन विद द क्रिमिनल रिकॉर्ड इज हैविंग 3 times मोर विनेबिलिटी देन द पर्सन हु आर गुड पर्सन विथ नो क्रिमिनल रिकॉर्ड. बिकॉज ए क्रिमिनल पर्सन with the criminal record, he is having muscle power, he is having lot many people behind him, he is having the financial muscle, he is in position to really he enjoy higher benevolency. It is very unfortunate that we elect such people and how they are having high benevolency. And the political party, those who are really joining hands to capture power, so national interest is nowhere. Now there's a second point that the law are enacted in their favor even without any deliberation. So their pay hikes have been done. If you decide the pay of bureaucrats, there's a commission, pay commission, which works for the 5 years, 6 years, or sometime 8 years. And on great deliberation and analysis, the pay are fixed. But the politicians decide their own pay hikes and everything in no time. How many of you know that now you people, even if you are going in bureaucratic job and government job, you are not entitled for pension? Do you know this fact?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
since sir. Since when this provision came into the existence?
Sir, I think 2004, sir.
Very true. So since 2004, the person, those who have contributed their whole life in the public service, they will not be entitled for the pension. While these politicians, if they remain MLA, MP or any public representative for one day, they are entitled for the pension. Is it fair?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Really unfair.
No, sir.
So no, now...
So they got double pension.
Not double pension. I've been told I need to verify it. But somebody told me at least there's one politician whose wife after death is getting 7 pension. Somebody very responsible person said, though it is difficult for me to believe, but then I have to find out that how many portfolio he was holding and how he is getting 7 pension. But at least he is getting multiple pension. This thing is very sure. So if he is MLA, he will get the pension for MLA. He will become MP, he will get the pension for MP. If he is a Parsad, he will get the pension for Parsad. So he is entitled for the multiple pensions, right? So he can be the person of the criminal record, and 42% politicians with the criminal record, they are the lawmaker. They will be getting pensions also. and they are doing what is suiting to them. They talk, say, Constitution was having a provision for the reservation for 10 years. Even after lapse of 75 years, why do we need to continue reservation? There's a difference between the caste-based reservation when a person whose father has been or holding a very senior post, IAS, IPS, etc., how he is at the disadvantage and he is getting the advantage of the reservation and becoming IAS and IPS. Is it to the really advantage to community or it the advantage is being accrued to few only, number one. Number two, why we should not support, because if some inferior person is coming in the public service, that inferiority complex will be a great problem because his behavior will not be balanced. So why we should not have n number of the positive supportive things? Why we should not have n number of the things so that the person who is having some handicap, financial handicap, background handicap, historical handicap, he should be supported so that he can acquire merit. But the reservation must vanish. Now, I will ask one question. Who will bring these changes? These politicians will never bring these changes because they will lose vote for it. Do you agree with this?
Yes. Sir, those who are filled income tax return, their must be reduced, sir.
It is question of not income tax return. We have to, dekhiye, there say you are as people of the computer science, right? And electronics and it is believe in the binary 0-1. Either it should exist or it should not exist. So it must go, right? Reservation per se must go. Abhi very recently, through the amendment in the Constitution, it has been again extended for 10 years. It means irrespective of the party, people will be doing or taking things which is politically convenient to them, that will help them to stay in power, not on their merit, but by distributing freebies, by distributing this kind of the reservation and rewards, and it will be at the cost of the merit. How anybody can become a doctor with the zero mark or with minus marks?
The reservation only for education, not for job reservation.
Why don't you want to support a person so that he should enjoy the merit? Why you want to really give that a feeling that he is in service, he is in education system with the inferior merit? Because that handicap will always be there in their mind and their behavior will never be balanced. So I am saying why you should not support him by providing coaching, books and other things, but try to bring him to a particular level. Hum gareeb kehke free bhi baant rahe hain, free bhi baant ke hum apni public ko nikamma bana rahe hain. Freebie is not good for the country. Freebie is very bad for the country. So the better course of action is ke usko payment karne ke liye sacham banaye. यदि कोई व्यक्ति आज पेमेंट देने के लिए वो नहीं है तो पेमेंट में भी डिफर्ड बट वी मस्ट क्रिएट द कैपेसिटी टू मेक द पेमेंट दैट्स व्हाई आई एम सेइंग क्राइम फ्री भारत इज नॉट पॉसिबल विदाउट क्रिएटिंग हेल्थ एंड वेल्थ एंड आई एम सेइंग वंस इवन यू क्रिएट वेल्थ यू हैव टू रियली टेक केयर ऑफ द वेल्थ चैनलाइजेशन आल्सो आई विल टेक एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द पंजाब which is a relatively rich state. It is a food bowl of our country. Productivity of the agriculture is very high, though on account of overuse of the water, fertilizer, and pesticide, which is basically creating problem for the underground water also. And majority, many people, they are suffering from the carcinogenic disease, that is cancer. And many cancer trains are plying from Punjab to the Delhi and Punjab to Mumbai and other places of the treatment, specialized places of the treatment for the cancer. You must have read in newspaper that 80%, almost 80% of the youth from Punjab, they are having the problem of the drug and the drug mafia by having the patronage of the politician. So if we are not careful, if we will blindly create wealth, that is also not good. Wealth should be created with a advanced planning for the wealth channelization. So wealth should go for the constructive things. It should be creating happiness. It should be creating entertainment. It should be creating culture. It should create the value system. That kind of the thing should also go somewhere. When the person is the devoid of the character, they are becoming your icon. They are becoming the decision maker. They will never allow that kind of the culture to come. So a time has come that people like you, those who are working in the field of the technology, they should not work for the internship, but they should work for creating technology, softwares and hardwares to create a system which should be in position to keep an eye basically, and everybody should be in position to do his job, and he is not in position to do negative things. All of you know that there was a great agitation for Lokpal Bill. आप लोगों को उसे देखने का मौका मिला भी, बहुत ज्यादा पुरानी बात नहीं है. Have you heard about that agitation of the Anna Hazare for Lokpal?
Yes, sir.
So how many of you know that finally Lokpal Act was created? Are you aware of that?
No, sir.
Okay, so Lokpal Act was enacted by UPA government, and Lokpal has been posted by the present NDA government. Do you know the name of the Lokpal?
No, sir.
So Lokpal has been posted, who took care that even his name is not known to the public. Kya hame aise institutions create karna chahiye? Those they are there to serve their or grind their own acts. Kya Lokpal isliye post kiya gaya tha ki uska naam bhi public ko malum na pade, ya isliye post kiya gaya tha ki he should take all the actions so that the corruption should be rooted out from Indian India.
I don't know.
आप लोगों को कुछ कहना है इस बारे में?
No, sir.
नहीं, you don't have any opinion कि जो है आप ये इतने बड़े जो है ना
सर, it was created for stop the corruption, sir. So it was created for the stopping the corruption.
The motto was never to be famous, sir. The motto was never to be famous. It was.
नहीं. He should do the thing.
Motto was for the working.
So I mean, if he will work, then public will come to know about it. How anybody can work without Johanna, it is coming in the knowledge of the public domain. Because if he is working, then he will be working on the case, he will be catching some corrupt officials, deals with the politicians basically. So chief minister, minister and prime minister, and those will be in his so it means he has to really catch them for their negative action. So it means that it is not question of having act, but it should have the provision when not all for the making ineligibility, non-performance should also be included as a part of ineligibility. Do you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
So if you are holding any public office, it is not that you commit the crime and then you become, say, basically, pagal ho jaye, tab aap jo hai na, us post ko hold karne layak nahi honge. Why we should not talk that you have to do your performance will be evaluated on these yardstick, and if you are not in position to touch this minimum yardstick, you will be treated as ineligible for holding the public office. जो बात अभी अपन लोकपाल के लिए कह रहे हैं वही बात हम जो है नेताओं के बारे में कहना चाह रहे हैं कि जब जो है ना नॉट ओनली दैट यू शुड नॉट हैव द यू शुड बी फ्री फ्रॉम द क्रिमिनल रिकॉर्ड यू शुड नॉट हैव एनी क्रिमिनल रिकॉर्ड टू योर क्रेडिट आई एम सेइंग यू शुड कंट्रीब्यूट पॉजिटिवली यदि एक व्यक्ति जो है एमपी या एमएलए रहने के बाद उसने ना कोई क्वेश्चन किया ना पब्लिक डिबेट किया हिज कंट्रीब्यूशन इज एब्सोल्युटली जीरो Why on account of non-performance he should become eligible to compete in an election? Do you agree with this?
How long will we be talking
of the negative dimension of performance when why we should not talk about the positive dimension also? So friends, we will continue to discuss and having the deliberations. I am thinking that we will be having few sessions. Those will be non-technical session when we will be talking about such things. And then slowly I will I would like you to do your internship in a little different way. First thing would be, if you don't know anything, that knowledge should be captured as fast as possible. I would like you to, each group should have a kind of a briefing from me so that you are supposed to make a problem statement for your internship. It means you have to create solution, you have to create software, you have to create that things as another part of it, because there will be different kind of the software using different kind of the technology. So everything will not be, say, image processing. Everything will not be AI, ML, or deep learning. But various technologies would be used depending upon the problem statement. As you understand that a lot of research is going in different part of the country. And if we are not updating ourselves, then we will be creating obsolescence. We will be creating inferior solution. So I want that after listening me, you people should go for doing a literature survey. You should list out the research paper, and then you have to discuss, you have to come out with the literature survey, and let it be a proper in the form of an article. And we will try to publish it in the magazine, and we will try to publish it on our website also, right? So that your work should be somewhere reflected. That, and then the concept note will be revised in the light of the literature survey, in the light of the new research and development, in the light of the new algorithm. So we will not only creating solution, we would like to create a state of art solution. Now, once we have consolidated and defined our problem statement after literature survey, then we have to work on process flow diagram. We should talk about the wireframes. We should talk about the backend coding and front-end coding. We have to talk about that, how it will go in the databases and how that different logic and data analytics will work. And how finally that backend coding and front-end coding, then they will be debugging, and version one will come, should come into the existence, right? And if you are already working on the previous version, then the version two should come on, version three should come. Here I would like, when you are writing code, you should write the code. So your literature has to come, deliberation has to come. Those deliberations should be the part of work which we should be submitted to the Crime Free Bharat, because that should be available to the next batch who will be taking the baton ahead. And I would like then when you are writing code, in bracket you can write the elaboration, so the person who will be next working on it, he should not really waste time in understanding what had been written, what is the your codes are, what you are intending to achieve by writing those commands. That should be elaborated, if required, even in few lines, so that your work should remain stay relevant to the next batches, and it should they should not say it was all rubbish and they are again starting from scratch. Otherwise, if it will be working that way, then we will be always creating version one only, but we must create version two, version three, version four, and these will be on the basis of the new and newer development. Most advanced thinking, even the research and algorithm which has come into the record, say previous night, we should try to capture that. Are you ready to do the internship in this mode?
Yes, sir.
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 Great. So I will request Sumit and Manish. I don't know Manish is or Sumit, they are present. Otherwise, whosoever is present should convey to them that there's already a document in which all these things, they are already documented. That should be shared with all interns so that they should keep in mind. It means there has to be one session where I will be elaborating what is our problem statement. Because this internship is intended to create solutions. It is just not an internship by created by the few organization for just an internship certificate and it is their business. It is not the business of the Crime Free Bharat. Crime Free Bharat is trying to create solutions. It is not limiting itself to the only the software, but it is even eyeing on hardwares also. And it is creating them. It intends to convert them into a startup. So you should be ready that your concept, can it becomes the a startup? Crime Free Bharat is a NGO. Crime Free Bharat very soon will be a trust, and it will be a foundation with a as a listed company also. And we intend whatever we are saying, we will come with the full mechanism to translate into the action. So whether it is agriculture, whether it's so, we have almost 13, 14 committees has been formed with the agriculture universities, those who basically be working for agriculture field. We would be in position to really help them in capturing their own soil sample. We will be knowing which farmer, what is the quality of the soil, and that soil input will be upgraded every year. So that exactly what organic fertilizer should come, in what micronutrients that soil is deficient, can we use the microbe of that particular micronutrients so that we can compensate that dimension of the soil. I mean, that kind of very micro level thinking is there. So very soon you will be having an opportunity that probably we will be making a cross fertilization, when the people from the different arena, they should join and create models, create technology, create software, create hardware, and create companies. And the company will not, we will not be distributing knowledge. We will be converting into the services and the products. And the people, those who would be helping that, they will be getting the revenue stream for that. So nobody will be employee. Everybody will be a stakeholder in the company. Everybody would be getting revenue stream for doing the work. And whatever work will be done, the revenue stream will be credited to the account at that very moment of the time. Now imagine a situation, ek bahut hi gareeb vyakti hai, usne thoda sa kaam kiya, usko usi samay revenue stream pahunch gayi, wo usse apne liye शाम का खाना खरीद सकता है. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट?
यस
सर. यस सर. इस तरीके का
3 मिनट सर, द सेशन इज एंड सर. 3 मिनट
आई थिंक नाउ आई थिंक नाउ वी शुड नॉट मूव इट फर्दर. आई थिंक इट इज अ टाइम टू क्लोज इट. सो आई विल से दैट आई थिंक आई कुड शेयर माय फीलिंग विद यू. I want my interns should have a feeling that they are not doing internship. They are in a cause of nation building. We together will make it happen. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank
you, sir. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Bye bye. We will be having more elaborate sessions, and each one of you, we will be getting a kind of a briefing about the various problem statement. And I think this time your experience would be different than the previous interns, because I decided to take Rian in my hand.
Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Goodbye. God bless you.
Okay, sir. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you, sir. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Thank you, sir. Jai Hind, sir.
Happy Raksha Bandhan.
Yeah, आप सबों को भी रक्षाबंधन की बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं, बहुत बहुत बधाई.
Same to you, sir. Same.
Thank you, sir.